Hello, my name is Tasha, and I am a current student at a university in Oklahoma. And today I want to discuss some of the differences between Middle Eastern universities and American universities and what to expect. First of all, if you got accepted into an American university, congratulations. That is a huge accomplishment. Now, just to kind of help you get along and help you get through the process of what to expect and what not to expect. First of all, whenever you go to an American university, you are expected to get your textbooks right away. Some classes don't require you to have every textbook that they say that you need to have. You usually will not know this until the first day of class. But if you want to save money on textbooks, it is better to order your books in advance. If you order books from like Amazon or Barnes & Noble, these type of places online can maybe get you around 50% off. But if you wait, you can go to a bookstore and still find the books you need. It's just usually a little bit higher in price. Depending on your major of what you study, you can spend either $200 on books or maybe even $1,000 on books. A lot of scientific books are very expensive. Although, you might ask some of your friends who have taken the class before you, because then maybe you could either share a book with someone, or borrow their book, or buy their book at a cheaper price. Although, make sure you watch out for different editions, because they like to change those too. Something that is good to do, especially as a foreign student who may not be used to the language, is to go introduce yourself to the professor. A lot of times, professors will have so many students that they won't even notice that you're there. You should go and make yourself known. Say, hello, my name is, and I am from. I just wanted to introduce myself. If you do this, the teacher will know that you're there, and that way they can help you if you have an issue later. Just as well, they have a lot of students in their class. A lot of times, teachers cannot accommodate you. So you will have to accommodate them, meaning you will have to go to them if you need help. They don't always come to you. A way that you can do this is by going to the office hours. At every school, every teacher is required to have office hours, where they must be in that office for a certain amount of time. Now, this might be different than what you're used to in the Middle East. Here, they're not always there if you say that they're going to be there, if you think they're going to be there. But in America, they have to be there. So you can go there for anything. If you don't understand a question, if you don't understand the prompt for your paper, anything. They're there to help you.